My name is Garth McKenzie, and I'm a technical analyst and an ETF strategist with traderscorner.co.za. Today, I'm taking a look at the S&P 500 and the current bear market rally, which is unfolding quite aggressively at the moment. And I also take a look at the VIX and an ETF that we can trade if we're looking for the VIX index to move lower. My first chart today is the S&P 500 on a daily chart basis. Now, what's interesting here is that obviously the market has bounced very aggressively off the recent lows that we saw in mid-March. This 26.35 level is a big technical level, which has now been breached to the upside. I've mentioned on previous occasions that I think it's possible that this bear market rally could see the S&P 500 stretch up into the region between the 50% retracement and the 61.8% Fibonacci retracement. And those levels come in at about 2800 and then up at about 2935. We typically refer to that region between the 50% and the 61.8% retracements as the ambush zone. Now, my sense is that we could see the market squeezing up into that area. We're currently seeing what looks like fear of missing out, FOMO, by those who perhaps didn't buy at the bottom. And I think also at the same token, we're seeing those who've possibly shorted the market too early, looking for a leg lower, are now starting to be squeezed. So you got the double whammy effect of those FOMO buyers and the short squeezers starting to actually push this S&P 500 higher. So my sense is that if we get up into that ambush zone, that might be where this move exhausts, and I possibly look there for a reversal to start looking on the short side on the S&P 500. But for now, it certainly seems the upward bias is very much intact for the short term anyway. The next chart shows an hourly graphic of the S&P 500. And here you can see that break above 26.35 more clearly. That essentially is a bullish break for the near term, and it projects a move up to 28.20 if we take the height of that range and project that distance to the upside. And once again, that target area would fall into that ambush zone that I spoke about on the previous chart, looking at the region between the 50% and the 61.8% retracement of this entire sell-off that we saw recently. Now, the next chart takes a look at the VIX index. This is the volatility index as measured by the Chicago Board Options Exchange. What you saw recently was a massive spike up in the VIX, up to 80, but as is expected, when the market starts to recover, like it's doing at the moment, you start to see volatility levels begin to slip lower. The VIX recently broke down below 50, which is a big technical level. That to me suggests that we could see the VIX heading even lower, possibly down towards 30, which is the next major technical level. Now, my final chart today takes a look at an ETF. This is the ProShares Short VIX Short-Term Futures ETF. The share code is SVXY. I've spoken about this one before, and what I've mentioned before is that if you feel that the volatility in the market does start to dissipate, then what one could do is look to buy this ETF, because this ETF rises when volatility contracts. I've got it on an hourly chart here, and you can see also a 15-period exponential moving average is plotted on the chart here. Whilst this ETF is trading above that 15-period exponential moving average, it looks to me like the bias is to the upside. There's a gap in the chart with this VIX ETF, this short VIX ETF, at about $35.50 and up to $37.50. So my sense is that if volatility continues to contract, then this ETF probably moves higher, and you could see it trading up into that region between, say, $35 and $37 per share on the ETF. So keep an eye on that as a possible trading opportunity in the days ahead. That's all I've got time for this week. I'll be back again next week with more market analysis and a look at some other ETFs.